Here we had calculated this potential energy is QVR for a single charge. For a single charge in any external electric field, and as you know, electric field has an associated potential V. So we had calculated this thing. Now let us see that what is the definition of electron volt. Thus, if an electron with charge Q is equal to E is equal to 1.6 into 10 to power minus 19 coulomb. So this you know, what is the charge on electron is accelerated by a potential delta V is equal to 1 volt. So see this delta U, and let Q be an electron. So charge is minus E, charge on electron, and it is accelerated by a potential 1 volt. Okay, 1 volt. It would gain energy Q delta V. Simply put, Q delta V is equal to 1.6 into 10 to power minus 19 joule, because voltage difference is 1 volt. So this would be the difference. This unit of energy is defined as 1 electron volt. This energy unit, very small unit, where electron is accelerated by potential of 1 volt. How much is this? This is 1 electron volt. 1 electron volt is equal to 1.6 into 10 to power minus 19 joule. This is how this electron volt has come. The units based on electron volt are most commonly used in atomic, nuclear and particle physics. So there are some other forms of this. 1 kilo electron volt, as you know that 10 to power 3 is kilo, so kilo electron volt. Million electron volt, million is 10 to power 6. Giga electron volt, giga is 10 to power 9. And tera electron volt is, tera is 10 to power 12 electron volt. So we have different type of units, and we use this thing in nuclear and particle physics. So remember the definition of electron volt. Electron volt is simply when we take an electron and accelerate that with a potential of 1 volt, that becomes an electron volt. You can easily remember, an electron volt is when an electron is accelerated by a potential of 1 volt, that is an electron volt. And how can you calculate? You know the charge on electron 1.6 into 10 to power minus 19, delta V or V is 1. So simply this much, 1.6 into 10 to power minus 9. Now it is energy. You must know this is energy. So this must be in joule. This is no longer in coulomb. Okay, this is no longer in coulomb. This is now in joule. Let us move to the second part. Now, potential energy of a system of two charges in an external field. So now we are moving from one charge to two charge. Let us say there are two charges. What are two charges? Q1 and Q2. Again, located at R1 and R2. Let us say there are two charges. This is Q1. This is Q2. And there is some origin O. Distance of this is R1. And for this position vector is R2. Again, these are vectors. These are vectors. Okay. First, we calculate the work done in bringing charge Q1 from infinity to R1. So, what we want to calculate? So, potential energy of a system of two charges. And again, these systems are in an external field. These are in an external field. It is not the case that we are bringing in with where there is no field. There is some electric field. If there is an electric field, there must be some potential before. As we know that external electric field E is always delta V upon delta L and mod of these. Okay, so this we know. So there must be some potential, and we are bringing these charges under the consideration of these potentials. So let us first consider, and again, potential at infinity, V infinity is equal to 0. So we are bringing this charge Q1 from infinity to this position, which is at R1. Okay, this is first point. In some external electric field, so total work done, as we calculated previously, so total work done in this case is Q1 VR1. Okay, so bringing charge Q1 from infinity, so we are bringing this from infinity to R1. So work done is Q1 VR1, as we had seen previously, that was simply QVR. So now this time R is replaced by R1 and Q is replaced by Q1. So that is the simply work done. Similarly, now there is another charge. So now this charge Q1 has brought to this point R1, and we have to bring another charge Q2 at R2. Again, we are bringing this from infinity. So this has come, and work done in bringing this is Q1 VR1. Now this charge will have two considerations. First, bringing this charge from infinity to this point R2. So similar term will come when we work against the external field. So this is Q2 VR2. Okay, so charge is now Q2 and the position is R2. The work done is simply for 2 is Q2 VR2. This was W1. Now what is new thing is that now this charge Q1 is already there. This charge Q1 is already there, hence it will apply an external field, also additional external field. And in that case, what would be the work done? So work done on Q2 against the Q1. So now we have to see the what would be the work done. So as we calculated in the previous examples, this will be simply Q1 Q2 upon 4 pi epsilon naught upon R12. So how did we calculate this? The charge Q2 into potential. And what is the potential? Potential due to 1 is Q1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught, and the distance between them is R12. So this is Q1, this is Q2, and this was at R1, this was at R2, and distance between them is R12. So this is the work done. So now we have three terms: this Q1 VR1, this Q2 VR2, this another term because of the 1 and 2, which is Q1 Q2 upon 4 pi epsilon naught R12. So remember, when we consider that square, so we were considering the potential only because of the charge. For first charge it was nothing. When we brought second, we were considering the potential due to this first charge. When we brought third charge, we were considering potential due to first and second charge. When we brought fourth charge, we were considering the potential due to first, second and third charge altogether. This time we have already some potential there. We consider that already some potential is there, and we are bringing this charge 1. So hence some work must be done. And we brought second charge, so this second charge has to work against this external field as well as against this first charge. So there must be total three terms. Previously what we calculated, when we brought first charge there was no term, when we brought second charge there was a term because of this first charge. So hence zero term and one term because of the first charge. Now we have three terms, because first charge will have non-zero term because there was an external field, second charge will have one term because of this external field, and third term because of the first charge, this Q1. So there we will have total three terms. So let us all together add all together these terms and let us see what is the total work done. So total work done in bringing Q2 to R2 is Q2 VR2, and this term Q2 upon 4 pi epsilon naught, and total potential energy is sum of all the work done. So total work done in assembling the configuration is Q1 VR1, Q2 VR2, and this third term Q1 Q2 4 pi epsilon naught R12.